So we've been in Mysore for about 3 months now. We moved in December of 2020. And one place that we haven't visited till now is Devraja Market. Now, Devraja Market is not really a tourist place because it stocks things which are of essential needs for Mysoreans on a daily basis. My neighbor comes to this market every Sunday to buy fresh fruits and vegetables, and we still haven't been here. So it's a sad thing that it took us 3 months to come to Devraja Market, but finally I'm here. And the idea is not just to showcase, you know, what it is from a tourist perspective, but we thought, why not come here and buy groceries and make a video. So we are trying to kill two birds, like they say, in one bullet. But we don't like killing birds, so let's not use that example, right? So what I've done is I've made a list of things that I need to buy, and while I'm buying these things, I'm also going to talk to you a little bit about the history of Devraja Market. So let's see what things my wife has asked me to put on the list. There's Nanjangud banana, so there's Nanjangud rasabale, it's a type of banana, pineapple, muskmelon, onions, tomatoes, some flowers, cucumber, palak, coriander, lemons, coriander seeds, bhindi, and other vegetables that I can find. So let's go inside and see what all you can find and whether it's actually cheaper than the other markets that you find close to your home, in Mysore specifically. So yeah, at the end of it, we'll do a tally of all the things we bought and see if it actually is cheaper. If it's cheaper, then I may keep coming back to this market with my wife Sarika and my cousin Tithi while we live in Mysore. Come on. Let's go, but if I keep walking with this like this, it's a bit weird, no? I don't want to walk with this, yeah. It's a damn. So Devraja Market was built, I mean, it was started around the reign of Tipu Sultan. It started off as a weekly market. I bought some marigolds for 20 rupees, half a kilo, because that's the lowest that you can buy. This is a wholesale market, so you have to really bargain, but you get all varieties of flowers. So whether it's marigolds, jasmine, roses, all sorts of flowers which are either used in decoration or they are used to offer to God for worship. Everything is available. The best thing to do is to come here during early mornings on weekends when, you know, there are all kinds of flowers available. Even if you're not going to buy any flowers, if you just walk through the market, it's a lot of fun. I'm having to speak at the peak of my voice because there's so much noise around me. I don't know whether this is getting captured or not, whether you can hear me or not, because everybody is really active and trying to sell their flowers. So it's a sight to behold. It's a lot of fun to be here, and I hope you get the chance to come to Devraja Market and come to the flower section. Now the flower section is in the south part of the market, if I'm not wrong. So the market is really huge. It has about 800 shops and it has 4 different gates. That's the flower market. The rest of it I'll talk to you about a little later. And from what I know, in the 1900s, Nalwadi Krishna Raja Wadiyar, under his guidance, this market was built into a central place and it was formalized. And I think after that, it's become a daily market. And this market is really interesting because it's spread over 3 acres. All the sections are divided into what you get in that particular section. So it's either fruits, which is towards the north side, there are vegetables in the south side, there are flowers on other side. So you can come into a specific entrance knowing what is it that you want to buy. So it's very well laid out, it's fairly clean for a market of its kind, and it's very well organized. Okay, so we found a place where they are selling tomatoes. He's selling tomatoes at 8 rupees kilo. 8 rupees kilo, that's probably the cheapest I've heard tomatoes. I don't know for how long. In fact, I don't even remember when tomatoes were as cheap as 8 rupees kilo, because probably that time I was not really buying vegetables. I was wasting time doing other things. I was still single at that point in time. So now that I'm married, 8 rupees kilo tomato seems like a very tempting thing, you know. So yeah, 8 rupees kilo, and Sarika is picking up the tomatoes. I don't know if you saw that. So this market can be a steal. So we will continue with the rest of the vegetables and fruits in a while. Right now, our tomatoes are getting weighed. So in Devraja Market, there's this one big section which is completely dedicated towards bananas. In fact, bananas are an important crop or important produce from this region in and around Mysore. What I read is that in Devraja Market, you get about 40 varieties of different bananas. Even when we were walking outside, there were a lot of shops which were selling bananas. Okay, so I'm here in Devraja Market and we bought 2 kgs of Nanjangudu Rasabede and one Evlakki type of banana, and we bought it from Mr. Somanna. So I'm going to ask him a few questions. He's been in this market for the last 37 years. How do nim shop alli tumba running banana yavdu yavdu baale
Evlakki baale pach baale Nanjangudu Rasabede.
Okay. ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಲ್ಲದ ಇದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸಿವ್ ಯಾವುದಿದೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ರೇಟ್ ಯಾವುದು
ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ರೇಟ್ ನಂಜನಗೂಡು ರಸಬಾಳೆ
ಯಾಕೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ರೇಟ್ ಇದೆ
ಅದು ತುಂಬ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿರ್ತದೆ ತಿನ್ನೋಕೆ ಟೇಸ್ಟ್ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಜನ ಇಷ್ಟಪಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಜನ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ
ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಸೋಮಣ್ಣ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೀ ಫ್ಯೂ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಹಿ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ಕೆಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸಂಟ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ 37 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಗೋ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ but the market remains the same. So that's a very interesting point about Devraja Market. He says that at his shop, they sell about 8 to 10 varieties of banana, which includes Evlakki, there's Nanjangudu Rasabede, and there are some other varieties which I couldn't really catch the name of. But definitely this is one of the biggest market for bananas anywhere here in this region of Mysore, Bangalore, Southern Karnataka. Besides that, he starts his shop at 7 in the morning, which means he starts his day earlier than that. And they are open till about in the evening, about 8-9. So it's a long day for these guys, and he knows a lot about bananas. In fact, we've grown some bananas, as in we have some produce of bananas at home, and he told me how to ripen them, because it sometimes needs some effort. You can't just leave it and they don't ripen on its own. You have to put them in a box, and that's how they ripen. So a lot of interesting stuff if you are into fruits and vegetables and stuff, and we'll move on to the next thing that we want to buy. And we've bought, this is our stash. So now we will go back to our list of things that we were supposed to buy and how much did we pay for it. Let me get my phone. I have made notes. Okay, so I start off with marigolds. We took half kg, so the flowers, that was for 20 rupees. We took coriander seeds, 250 grams of good quality, 250 grams of second quality, total 65, 2 kgs of onions at 40, which is 20 rupees kilo. Potato 1 kg at 25, garlic 250 grams at 40, small onions 250 grams at 15, coriander 10 for one big bunch, spinach or palak 20 for 5 bunches, dill 10 for 2 bunches, bhindi 10 for half a kg, cucumber big ones 20 for 4, Nanjangudu Rasabede, which is the banana which is probably the most expensive banana that they sell in this market. It was for 70 rupees per kilo. I bought 2 kilos, that's 140. And Evlakki, which is like sort of the more commonly found banana, for 50 rupees 1 kg. So I bought all of this and spent 475 rupees. That's all. I really feel that this market is about 20 to 30% cheaper than what you will find in your local shop, at least in Mysore. We are shooting this video on 4th of April 2021. So do consider that all of these rates are, of course, changing from time to time, probably every day. So don't hold me against the rates that you just heard. And as far as social distancing is concerned, we've tried our best. Apart from the time when I'm speaking on video or on video, we've maintained, I've wore a mask, so that's that. So it was all in all a great fun, good Sunday shopping, that's it. So I wasn't alone here at Devaraja Market. Sarika also braved this market along with me, and of course Tithi is behind the camera. So for braving this market and being with me, of course I'd like to offer something like a rose to Tithi. But because this is red in color, I'm going to offer this to Sarika instead, my wife. And
we live heavily kissed. What was I thinking?
Koi baat nahi, bol.
We live happily ever after.
She pronouncing happily on video was so difficult for Sarika. So yeah, Devaraja Market, good fun.
Bye.
Hey, if you liked that video, then go ahead and follow Eccentric Sachin. You can also go ahead and smash that subscribe button and hit the bell notification. Until we meet in the next video,
keep traveling.
Hey.
कुछ पीना क्या?
कान में लगा।